Tonight, born into the wrong body, Cher's firstborn used to be Chastity. Now Chaz is focusing attention on sexual identity and the confusion, conflict, and agony it can cause.
It's very important to me that people accept me as a transgender female.
Alexis Arquette made the transition from man to woman with the help of her famous supportive family. She's here, along with a former reality show contestant, the mayor of an American town, and a 13-year-old with his mom. They know something about transgender issues firsthand. Their brains tell them one thing, their bodies say something else. Then, John and Kate's sextuplets have got some competition. Meet the new kids on the block. Next, on Larry King Live. I'm Dr. Drew Pinsky, sitting in for Larry King. Chaz Bono is not the only high-profile case of someone transitioning to another sex. Actress Alexis Arquette was born a boy. Her documentary, She's My Brother, was featured at the Tribeca Film Festival. Dr. Gary Alter is a plastic surgeon and urologist and an expert in genital reconstruction. Both of them can help us better understand what this is all about. Alexis, how do you feel about Chaz's preparing for surgery and
create real solutions. Black in America 2. Saturday and Sunday night, 8 Eastern on CNN.
Welcome back. Silverton, Oregon's mayor is the first openly transgender mayor in the United States. Stu Rasmussen is here with us to talk about his unique situation at City Hall and at home. Also joining us is Michelle Golland, clinical psychologist and contributor to MomLogic.com. Thank you guys for joining us. Stu, to you first.
Yes, sir.
Do you identify yourself? Well, where do you identify yourself in this spectrum we've been talking about tonight?
Well, it's like there's male and there's female, there's short and there's tall. I'm somewhere in between.
Do you identify as heterosexual?
Absolutely.
So you're heterosexual, and so it's like more of a cross-dressing, cross...
Well, it sort of gets to be a curiosity, because if I appear to be a female and like females, am I a lesbian or am I a male and straight? So it just kind of rattles around in your head for a while.
That's why I get confused. So the people in your town, I understand, think very highly of you. Have they pushed back at all? Have they had any reaction to your identification publicly as a woman?
I think we did the transition fairly slowly, and people had the chance to go, what's going on with Stu?
I imagine they said before the gender issues.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so they're used to you
they're used to
being
me.
A little trickster.
Yes, a little bit. And actually, very few people ask me about it, but my life partner, Victoria, got lots of questions from people. What's Stu doing? What's going on there?
Why stop where you stopped?
I got to a point where I've got exactly the body I want. I like what I see in the mirror. I didn't see any need to do anything further. Seems like it's a family show, but I like the sexual aspects of being a male, and I like the appearance aspects. And
how about your partner?
I have to be honest and say, although I look like I'm 45 years old, I'm actually 60, and that end of the relationship, it's more a, it's not a sexual relationship anymore.
It's a she, yes? She, Victoria, is that, I think.
She is very much a she.
Is she had a reaction to your transformation at all? Has she anything to say about it?
Well, this is certainly something that we discussed, you know, before doing it, and you know, it was like, honey, I'd really like cleavage, and she said, okay. So that was about the extent of the discussion. And she'd known I was a cross-dresser for years, and had sort of put up with my little peccadillos. And
I see. So she was something she'd come to be accustomed with you, and just as this is more of that.
This is more of that, and we are two exceedingly compatible people. We're deeply in love, and it's just the coolest relationship on the planet.
Now, Dr. Golland, people tend to get a little confused. I think it's because we in this program, we're talking about gender and sexuality as two separate topics, and they're both kind of on the move here at this desk tonight. And I think it confuses people. How do they understand this?
Well, I think what's so important to understand is sexual orientation is different than sexual identity, is different than gender identity. Sexual orientation is one's longing and romantic and passionate connected feelings, your drives towards either the same sex or the opposite sex or both sexes or no sex, or none.
And gender identity?
And gender identity is an enduring sense of self. I am a female. I feel myself to be a female, right? But when transgender people have the physical parts of a male, but their gender identity and what they feel inside is female.
Gotcha. We're going to continue this conversation with a brave 15-year-old and his mother. They're here. Their moving story about his life, the identity issues that they are both confronting. This is next. You're watching Larry King Live. And welcome back. We're joined now by 15-year-old Ryan and his mother, Fran. Ryan was born a girl and went by the name of Sarah until recently. Friends use male pronouns when referring to him, but mom still calls Ryan her daughter. Thank you for joining us, you guys.
Thanks for having us.
Now, Ryan, you're 15, is that correct?
Yes.
Do you get disturbed when your mom still refers to you as a female?
Sometimes I say he under my breath, but I don't know. I can't really correct her now.
When did you realize you were different?
When I was a little kid, I realized that something was just missing. I didn't really feel complete.
Did you say something to your mom right away or your dad? And if you did, how did you do that?
No, I didn't say anything to anyone. I kept to myself.
Was that hard?
Not really, because I didn't really know exactly what it was. I thought it was a normal thing to feel.
When did you first realize what this was?
I think 2 years ago, I met someone who was transgender, and I was like, well, that must be what I am. That's how I feel.
And Fran, mom, what was your reaction when, I guess I should say Sarah to you, when Sarah came to you about this issue?
I have to say I was supportive. I did tell her that there's really not much that could be done about that right now, and maybe it's better to kind of put it on the back burner and not worry so much about what your gender is.
Did you know what she was talking about at the time?
No, I really didn't understand so much. At first, she came out to me as being lesbian, and that really was not a very big deal to me at all. You know, it's my child, and no matter how she feels, I will always love her and be supportive of her. It's just
but you know, as
difficult.
A parent, but parenting is a tough job, and you can be sort of anxious about being a child. About having a child. So I would imagine when Sarah came to you with this, it provoked some anxiety. How did she present it, and how did you react?
She brought it to me by calling me outside to sit on the front porch, and she was crying, crying, because she feels different. And by different, what do you mean by different? So she expressed to me that she feels that she is a boy trapped in a girl's body.
Ryan, was that tough? I imagine that was very painful.
Yes, I was crying a lot. I really didn't know how to tell my mom, but I just felt like at that moment I had to tell her.
Do you want to have a surgery to have your gender status reassigned, Ryan?
Eventually, I'd like to get top surgery, but I'm not so sure about bottom surgery just because technology hasn't really advanced that much yet.
And then, Mom, how do you feel about that?
Whatever she feels comfortable doing.
Do you ever worry that this...
I just want her to be happy.
I understand that, of course, we all do as parents, but it's got to be, you know, confusing, anxiety-provoking, and do you ever worry that this is just a phase and she'll regret having the surgery?
I do think it could be a phase. It's when you're 15, you know, the world is a little bit confusing.
Well, and it's funny.
Just for your average 15-year-old.
Fran, it's interesting when you responded that way, several of our panelists that are here in the studio sort of cringe, like, no, this is something we live with our whole life. And so we're going to continue talking about that. But as a parent, you can understand, I can understand why you think, well, maybe this will change, maybe it will go away. But it is something that does tend to persist. And I want to thank both of you and wish you the best of luck. And Ryan is pretty cool having a mom you can go to and that loves you no matter what. So you've got a good situation there.
Thank you.
You're quite welcome. We will continue this discussion right after the break.
If you're in debt to the IRS for $10,000 or more, you don't have to take desperate measures to settle your account. All you have to do is put...
gotta call now.
To order, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-905-2216. That's 1-800-905-2216.
And we are talking about the transgender world and hope to get a better understanding of what this is all about. So, Dr. Golland, yes. Our panel is still here, obviously. I want to pick up the conversation where we left off with Fran Orion, which is what to do with adolescents that begin to step up with these symptomatologies.
Well, one of the things I would like to highlight is if your child is a teenager and they come to you with this, you've done something right as a parent.
The fact that they feel open enough to come to you.
The fact that they feel safe and open and are honest with you, that's enormous. Mm-hmm. And so you have to really, really accept that they are sort of trying to unburden themselves and that they feel safe enough with you to do so.
Is it a phase?
I would say most likely no.
Yes. You guys, panel, agree?
Well, I mean, it's different for every individual.
Isis says no. She's still with us.
Yeah, Isis doesn't agree.
But you guys, did you guys ever go through a period where you presented it to someone and they said, oh, you'll be okay, it's just a phase, family, friends?
Well, actually, my experience was, it wasn't necessarily with me, but I had somebody that I hired to work in my business who claimed to be transsexual, and she at the time was 17 or 18 and was surgery tracked and ready to go, and then 2 years later, I ran across her, and he had fathered a couple of children and was back as a male.
Well, I'd seen some data that sometimes in psychotherapy, people lose the desire for the surgery. And Isis, you say yes, that people told you it was just a phase?
Yeah, you hear that, especially like I'm African-American, so in our culture, you know, let alone being gay, being born around body is something that's really not heard of until now. So, of course, you hear things like it's a phase and you're going to get through it. And I'm just like, no, it's not a phase. But it's something that you have to tell yourself, and not really, it's one of those things you don't have to really prove to others. It's, you have to figure for yourself if that's what's really for you.
So, I want to go around the table here.
I did that, obviously.
I want to go around the table now and get some final thoughts. Alexis?
It's very important to me that people accept me as a transgender female, but it's ridiculous to a lot of people, and I understand that. Men and women are very, very similar. And I think the closer we can get to one another, the more we'll understand a lot of these issues.
Ryan?
For F to M's, I think it's a little bit interesting because growing up as female, if you're a tomboy, that's accepted. Versus M to F is growing up and maybe more effeminate, right. They'd be termed a sissy. Mm-hmm. And that's looked on down.
Pejorative terms, yeah.
Right. So it's a little bit confusing for me because I was accepted as a tomboy growing up, but that wasn't good enough for me. There was something else that was not selling right. I was very fortunate at age 24 to understand that I was transgender and to move forward with it.
And Stu?
Well, I actually grew up being a nerd, so I didn't have to worry about being described as a sissy. And honestly, where I am right now, I'm having more fun than a drunken cowboy with a brand new pickup.
Isis, you get the very final thought.
Well, I'm happy that this topic is coming up more and more because there are so many young people even that come to me and tell me that, you know, this is the way they feel, but they're scared to tell their parents. So I'm happy that it's out there more. So the more you see it, the more you'll realize that it's normal and that people are born like this, and it'll be easier for the next generation to come up and tell their parents. Like the young guy on here, like when I was 15, I couldn't do that. I didn't come out and tell my mother until I was 20. But by that time, I was already finished college and ready to move out and move to New York. So, you know, I'm happy that the children are able to do that now. And hopefully with this and with more other shows and just being out there more, that it'll be easier.
Well, I think you're right. And this has been a very, very interesting discussion. I want to thank all of you for being here and being so open. And now, move over, John and Kate. We're switching topics entirely. There's a new group of sextuplets. The word sex is in here, at least. New group of sextuplets on the block, and they are going to join us here in 60 seconds.